Does one truly understand how children with disabilities are treated? If you believe they are treated the same as everyone else, you are sadly mistaken. I dream to see a day where my sister is not thought of as a girl with a disability, but as a girl that is looked at and seen for who she truly is. Children with disabilities have rights, and so many times they are abused, ignored, and harassed. They are humans just as any of us. Yes, they are a little different, but aren't we all?
Say hi, everybody.
Hi. Who's this?
Mei-Mei.
My name is Riley Fluggy, and my sister was diagnosed with Down syndrome when I was 8 years old.
Can you give me a kiss?
Give me a kiss.
She sat me down and she said, she's healthy. She's just as any other baby, but she has this thing called Down syndrome. And at first I was only 8, so I really had no idea what it was, but I just went to the hospital. And when I saw her, I definitely knew that something was different about her, but, I mean, she was my sister, and I accepted her for who she was, so I've known her since day one, and that's who she's always been to me. To other people, outside of that, who don't know how to react to a person with disabilities, it's different. I mean, I go out into public with her, and people will stare, and it breaks my heart sometimes. There's little girls that'll point and be like, "Daddy, look at her. You know, she's different." And I know that they don't know any better, but still, that's how our society is. They point out differences or flaws. A main point that people need to understand is that what's wrong with being a little different, you know? And people with disabilities will teach you so much more than you give them. And honestly, you have to give them a lot more than you think, because they will amaze you and surprise you every day.
Thousands of people surrounding the world wake up every morning and are immediately faced with challenges. Did they wish for a life such as this? No, they were simply born with it. We as a society cannot control whether or not you were born with a disability, but we can control how you can react to it. The purpose of this documentary is to take the viewers on a journey to uncover the true difficulties and experiences that come with having a disability. What can we do as a society to assist the people who unfortunately have to endure these multiple impairments within their daily lives? As a group, we have set on a path to complete projects that will aid us in understanding and being able to truly empathize with children that we may not even know have to adjust to understand a concept even within a classroom. This is something nobody should have to endure alone, and we as a community need to pull together to solve the discrimination and separation that children with disabilities sustain.
Hi, I'm Kendra.
I'm Morgan.
That's Kate. This is a video diary in progress for our PBL.
We reached out to everyone we knew that could help us with completing our goal, from special education teachers to first-hand accounts. At this point, we were searching for input and advice to how to best achieve our message of awareness. We valued others' views on problems and situations based on the topic of children with special needs.
We interviewed Amy Fluggy, mother of three, one of which has Down syndrome.
I also gave birth to our daughter, who was diagnosed with Down syndrome after she was born.
How do you think people with disabilities are treated or treated differently?
Well, for Mason's instance, she looks different, so they automatically assume there are many things that she cannot do.
Oh, guys.
What color?
What? Red. Okay. Blue. Brown. Orange. Yellow.
Good job.
Good job. Have you ever heard of or do you believe that there are kids in the world with disabilities that are treated better or worse than kids with disabilities in the U.S.?
If you're going to be born with a disability, the United States is the place to be. For instance, the Ukraine, Russia, China, many of these countries, as soon as the babies are born, they're instantly taken away and put in institutions. If they're not adopted by the age of four, then they are placed in an orphanage for adults, and they're no longer adoptable, and they live the rest of their lives there.
What is your personal outlook on children with disabilities, and how are they a positive thing to our society?
I think that everybody, children with disabilities, given the chance, can really show. Like her. They can be pretty typical.
Boo!
Can you say hi? Children are, can be a,
what?
A very positive thing in the community. I've seen it firsthand, especially at Prairie. The children are integrated, and so now that Mason's in kindergarten, I see that the kids think of her as just like them. And so the younger that they're exposed to this, the better off she'll be as they get older, and it'll give her much more opportunity in life where she can go out and have a job and have a boyfriend and have friends and be able to be a very important person in our community.
What are you doing?
Children with Disabilities is an infographic that we made in order to spread information on our topic about the lives of children with disabilities. This brings awareness to important cases that many people are oblivious to. Disabilities are not always just physical, but can be mental too. They can hold people back from living what's called a normal life. With this infographic, we hope to show people in a very simple way that there is more to people with disabilities than a handicap parking tag. Over 650,000 people in the world are disabled. That is thousands of people who are neglected, subjected to physical, sexual, or psychological abuse, who do not receive medical care, and encounter several other hardships.
Autism Awareness Day, and we went, like, the national the color that you're supposed to wear for autism is blue, and we went up to all students at school that were wearing blue and interviewed them and asked them, like, if they knew the significance of today. Were you aware that it was National Autism Day?
No.
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 A lot of the kids, most of them didn't know really what the day was for. Didn't know what the day was for. This is why we're doing the PBL, is to raise awareness of it. And
next week we are going to do our simulation of going to the AP Spanish class.
Yeah, we're going to visit an AP Spanish class to sit through it and like see what it's like having a reading or a learning disability. Like
we're like putting ourselves in
their position.
Yeah, of how it would be like to like lack
something. Yeah, because most of us know, we all know Spanish, like we're in Spanish classes, but we're not fluent.
We're on like Spanish 1, so we understand a little bit.
Yeah, and the people that are in AP Spanish should be almost fluent by now. So there is no English allowed in that class, which is going to make it really difficult, but I think it'll just help us really understand and help us to be able to empathize with the people.
Yeah.
Okay, we're walking
the office to go sign in. We're not at the high school.
We are here to go to his home.
To the presentation rooms on your right. Mrs. Colby's room's on the left. This is the seat.
Whole simulation was about experiencing what it would be like to live as a person with a disability. Throughout the simulation, we are placed in an environment that only speaks Spanish in order to see how it feels to have a hearing or speaking disability. A value our society has is equality, yet when it comes to people with disabilities, it seems like that value is forgotten. They are left behind and are not cared for in a way that benefits them. No one takes the time to try to help or understand them. If people walk in their shoes, then there might be a change in how some people react when they see someone with a disability struggling.
I'm going to try to read this Spanish thing to you. Determine position on the map. The territory formed. North America from South with South America.
She's skipping around.
Here, Kate, you try to read a paragraph.
Go. Enter the principal groups. habitat. Something. Europe.
History of Panama.
Puerto Rico.
Live social, something about economy.
In the city of Panama, they realized the International Congress. I only understand like 5% of all the words.
They laugh at us because we don't know what we're talking about.
I don't understand much.
Don't really know what to say.
Okay, so it's the day after we went to the Spanish class.
When we were sitting there, you can like pick up on a few words and pieces, and I think that like when you have the learning disabilities that some kids do, I think that's kind of how they feel, is they understand like little parts of it, but just not completely. And you kind of get lost in it. You can't put it all together.
It was really hard to stay included because we didn't know what was going on.
Plus, it's easy to get left behind.
If I were somebody that had to go through that every day, I would be really frustrated with myself and with the teachers for not helping me.
Look at the words.
This is a cat.
That is a cat.
No, how old are you?
What I said.
Let's count. Ready? One.
One. Two. Three. Four. Five. One.
Six.
Six. Seven.
Seven. Seven. Who is that? You look so silly.
Meme.
Yeah, it's Meme.
And I think the reason why she is where she is today is because my mom has done a really good job with her since she was little, you know, taking her out into the world and teaching me and my brother just to treat her as any other person. Because when you shelter a person with disabilities, or, you know, you make them feel like they are different, then they're going to act different. And they just want to be accepted. They just want to be like everybody else.
When life leaves you high and dry.
Our journey was about uncovering the truth about children living with special needs. We hope to extinguish how people view them and how they are thought of less than any other human being. Each of us have experienced the same journey, but in different ways. Our goal is to bring justice to children with disabilities, and it is imperative that we the people stand out and bring change to the world one step at a time. Show empathy and place yourself in their shoes. Equality is a dream, but it can become a reality. We can help to make the change, but it will take every single one of us to stand up to reach the dream that one day children with disabilities be viewed as simply another child with a bright future. Special needs is a phrase misused often. When you focus on someone's disability, you'll overlook their abilities, beauty, and uniqueness. Once you learn to accept them and love them for who they are, you subconsciously learn to love yourself. Not only are these children making an impact daily, but they are unique and special to our community, and special to me. And long after you're gone, gone, gone. When you fall like a statue, I'm gonna be there to catch you, put you on your feet, you on your feet. And if your well is empty, not a thing will prevent me. Tell me what you need, what do you need?